And what are you seeing, in the industry in terms of dealing with or good strategies, successful strategies in dealing with the labor issue right now, the labor shortage?
I think one is you keep who you have with love. That's the first and foremost thing. Stop the leaking, stop the turnover. We've had horrible turnovers in the industry for years. And I really think employees are taking revenge on us as an industry. There was no safety net for them. And the Restaurant Relief Act came, what, a year and a half later? That was way too late for many of us. I had so many founders I was on the phone with many a night in tears, seeing that their business they worked 10, 20, 30 years to build destroyed overnight and laying people off and then not knowing what to do. And so that was heartbreaking. And if you're a young person, and let's face it, a lot of people, this used to be the stepping stone job. Well, this is now people's means of income. This is how they feed their family. When that was taken away with no insurance, no benefits, no recap, I keep on hearing that, oh, the government's paying people not to work. Really? $300 a month? That's not compensate for your income for what you really need. And these are some of the challenges that we've had. So when I say keep who you have with love, is starting point with John started off at the very beginning is culture. Now, I'm a longtime member of conscious capitalism, and the four credos and tenets of conscious capitalism start number one with higher purpose. Why do you exist? And if you have a purpose that is really magnificent and aspirational, people will stay for that and come for that. The other one is a stakeholder orientation. Everyone is included in the thought. It's not just the owner and the shareholders. It's not just the employees. It includes the customers. It includes your vendors. And when you have a stakeholder mentality, you'd be surprised what can come about. Many the companies that I've worked with, where the culture is really strong, they have survived and thrived as a result of this. The ones that had a toxic culture, there's the one that have gone bankrupt because they already were bankrupt emotionally and spiritually. And the difference now is that it just came to life manifest externally. They were already rotten to the core. The other one is conscious leadership. And this is what we're talking about, intentionality. What am I going to do today to keep my peace on the board? What can I do today to protect my employees? What can I do to service my guests? I mean, those are the kind of questions that get up every morning and ask the same question over and over again, and the answer is different. And lastly, conscious culture comes around the fact that if you really engage your employees in the solutions, we had restaurants, as was already discussed here, not only were they fed by their employer, but they formed their own little community gatherings to help on babysitting and helping with the child, not just child care, but also health visits and things like that, or when someone got sick. And that's a big piece of it. So the having that purpose in the culture is important, and meeting with them frequently, talking to them a lot, because you cannot afford to lose them. If you have that, then you can attract who you want.